Welcome to Qt Widgets and More. In today's episode, we will dive into type traits. That is, questions about types. Let's keep a clear eyes to the horizon. What is it we're trying to do with this mini-series? Well, I promised you a few times ago that by the end of next episode, you'll be able to read the code on your screen now. And if you look at that, you'll see that it says if const expression std colon colon is same v, the is same v, that's a type trait. It tests whether two types are the same, namely the std remove reference t input container and result container. And the other thing that it tests with after the ampersand is std colon colon is r value reference v and then the container there. The question is, what does this is same v do? Where do I find it? And could I even implement it myself? And the answer is surprisingly easy. Yes, you can. All it takes is a bit of understanding of template specialization. Does that ring a bell? That's what we talked about last week. Template, type name t, type name s. Struct is same. So I have a struct that is a templarized struct. Templarized class, whatever, on two types T and S, just as we saw last episode. Come on. And this struct has one variable, namely a static const expression bool, so it doesn't get more const than that, does it? Static const expression bool value equal to false, so can never change. And this is where you go like, where are you getting with this, Jesper? Well, check out the next one. Template, type name t, struct is same, tt. Okay, so this one here just takes the same type twice. So this is actually a more specialized version than this one up there. But it's the same type and it takes it twice. So when I do pattern matching on my template to fill out the t's, if I give it two things that are identical, it will match both of these. And then static const expression, bool value equal to true. And that's where you'll see down here. I'm now saying is int and int the same. So is same int and int this thingy here. It's a struct. It's a struct. It's not an instantiation of a struct. But that struct has a static variable called value. That's either this one or this one, and that one we can print out. So is same less than int comma int value. How about is same char and int? Well, we better run it, right? So is same int and int? Yes, they are. Is same char and int? No, they're not. And it's simply a matter of pattern matching. And I can show you that it's not just the letter int that is the same. We can call, using bar equal to int, and then I can say is int and bar the same, and hopefully it says yes they are. Disaster if it didn't. And I can do lots of stuff, but that is a type trait right where we have it. And again, it came from this template specialization I told you. Last episode, it was super hard to find something that was not weirdish without being a type trait. And that's exactly what you see here. We use this all over the place. Template type name T, yes, is same. No, they are not. Template type name T is same. Yes, they are, because my bar and my int both could match the T up here. And then this version was more specialized than this version. I suggest that you put your playback on pause now. Just go like, wow, that is cool. Because now after 2.5 episodes, I showed you something that is really starting to get into the realm of template meta programming. Before we proceed and look at is const next, let me just do a small advertisement here for our trainings. More specifically, I'd like to tell you a bit about the difference between an on-site training and a scheduled training. So in the scheduled training, you will go somewhere where we run the training. There will be other companies, people in there. It's of course more cost efficient if you're the only one to be trained. While the on-site training, we will come to your place, which is more cost efficient if you had lots of people to travel with, for one thing, but it also allows us to tailor the content more to your need. So I can't urge you enough to go and join one of our trainings. There's a link right up here. And now let's talk a bit about constant values. Let's try another one, because I'm trying to show you a pattern of this stuff here, but let's try another one. This time we'll test whether a type is const or not. Template type name T, struct is const, static const expression, bool value false. Okay, so the generalized version, the generalized type up here with a T can match anything, and that is not const. And then we have the specialized version. It's still on a template T here, but it's more specialized in the sense that it's not just T, it's const T. So due to the rules of choosing templates, your compiler will choose this one if it can match something that is a const T, and then the value is true. And let's just look at it down here, and we can run it again just so that we can see the output. I can even make the output bigger here. So we start with int. Is const int colon colon value? No, it's not. That's good. Is const const int? Yes, it is. And int const is also, so int const and constant is both of them const. Of course, it's just it's syntax. It doesn't change anything there. Of course, in metaprogramming, you are not writing stuff like is const. You're not writing stuff like is const const int. I can hardly say that. You're not writing this stuff here. You have a type and you want to know. So to our rescue comes this method called decaltype. Decaltype is a function that takes a variable and returns the type of that one. So here we are. Here we are. We have an integer x, of a variable x, and we're trying to say is x const, and we can ask it by decal value x. That's the type decal value. Decal type x. That's the type of x, and is that const? And it'll say nope. And by the way, we can also look at the real version, because std comes with exactly this is const, and we see std colon colon is const decal type. It looks exactly the same, except that they have is underscore while I have is capital C, and that's purely to avoid stepping on std's toes when I'm showing this to you. Okay, how about const in y? And as you can see, yeah, they both agree that this is const. So decal type, template specialization, and this concept of the compiler choosing the most specialized version of your class. It has a static const expression bool in there. Did you see the pattern? The pattern is always, I'm creating a struct, I have a static const expression bool value in that struct, and it's either false or true, depending on what I want. That must be possible to make somewhat generic, so I don't need to write all that same code over and over again. And of course it is. It's called integral constant. Let me show you what that looks like, because the first time I looked at it, it was like, what is this even C++ code? But it is. And you'll not get in that trouble when I've shown you this code. Do you remember the very first episode I told you that you could have templates with type, but you could also have template with values in them? And that's exactly what we'll be doing now. See, I have a template bool v. So this is a template where its specialization is on the value v. And it's simply a struct bool struct that has this static const expression bool value equal to v. And you're like, yeah, that looks good, yes, but what's going on here? Seriously? Well, it goes on in the sense that I have template type name T is const. Public bool struct false. Template type name T is const const T. public bool struct true. So now I actually have limited the whole body of this to be the whole body, that one line up here, to be looking like this. I got just a little bit closer, didn't I? You are a terrible audience, you know? You're not giving me credit whenever I work really hard. Yes, it wasn't a terrible much closer I got, but it's what the C++ standard has in it, or the header files. And what I'm trying to do here is to teach you to be able to read that code that is in the header files and understand it. So let's go one step further, and then it's exactly what is const, what you'll be looking at in the is const. And I'll even go and show you is const, okay? Okay, over here again. I now have template type name T, comma TV. Not as in television, TV. No, it's a template with two parameters. One is the type, and the second is a value of that type, and it's called integral constant. Static const expression T, value equal to V. Take a second to take that in. It's basically just a struct that is temporized with a type and a value of that type, and then it has an value in a static value in that struct with that value. Okay, so in C++ 17, we introduced this one. Yes, if I was involved in that. C++ 17 introduced the bool constant here. So template bool v using, so this is a template with using in here, using bool constant equal to integral constant bool v. So now bool constant is it temporized on the v exactly as we saw right over here where I had my bool structs. They just call it bool constant. That's okay. And now that's where the magic starts happening. Using false type equal to bool constant false, using true type equal to bool constant true. So now this is a fully instantiated version of my integral constant. The T is a bool and the value is either false or true. And my isConst now read template type name T struct isConst colon false type. And that's what I was like, what does that even mean when I saw it? Well, it basically means that from this false type, which is a bool constant, which is an integral constant of bool, I have this value in here, which makes it possible for me to write code like is false. I can't see it anywhere. Is constant. Well, that's not the one I want. I'll one over here. I can write is const less than int greater than colon colon. So that's what my false type and true type comes there. And I was like, but what does this mean? Well, it's just come on. That's what it means. Okay. Thank you very much for leaving the public out. That didn't make it easier for me to read. Finally, in C++ 17, we also got the ability of temporized variables, which looks like this. Template type name T, and then inline const expression bool. So this is a templarized boolean that is inline, and it is simply is const T colon colon value. That brings this that we had before here, where we wrote is const less than int greater than colon colon value, is const blah blah colon colon value. That means that we now can write is const underscore v for value less than int greater than, or is const underscore v const int, or well, one of those with a decal type, which would be what we really would like to do. Let's just celebrate for a second. Let's see the code on the screen again. And we actually are much more able to read what it says up there now. We have this transform, and it has an if const expression. I can tell you const expression without getting too much into the next episode. Const expression is a compile time test. So if either the if part or the else part will be simply thrown out and never even attempted at compiling. So if const expression std is same v, so we have this input container and we're removing references from it. So const reference is going to be, well, not the const, but the reference is going to be thrown away. And it's better not be a const to start with, otherwise it's not going to be very interesting. And so if the input container is the same type as the result container, hey, we know what is same we does now. So we're actually checking the type of the input container and the result container. And the second part is our value reference V, my input container double reference. So the input container's value there, or the input container, is that an R value that we get in there? And if that's the case, then we know that we got a container in that's going to be thrown away. And it's the same as the container we're going to put our result into. And in that case, we can reuse it. But I'm getting ahead of myself now. That is going to be for next week's Qt widgets and more. In the meantime, you say, oh yes, but this is so interesting. I really love to learn more about type traits. And I saw that you had stood colon colon is same V. How about more type traits? Can you give me them all? And the answer is absolutely not. Do you have any idea how many there is? Well, go to this link here, which is also in the description below if you didn't manage to click it right fast enough. There is lots and lots of those. There is value reference, is pointer, is union, is enum, is scalar, is const, is signed, and so on and so on. I'm just reading up from my screen here where I'm looking at it now. But there is lots of type traits that are very useful when you go further into template meta type programming. Until next time, you know what? Have a great time.